A very good morning to all students. We have started the 16th chapter of chemistry, that is green chemistry and nanotechnology. In the previous lecture, we have completed the green chemistry and now we have started the new topic, that is nanotechnology. Now, in this, we have studied about the introduction of nanochemistry, then what is meant by nanoscience, how do we define nanotechnology, why nano, what is the nanomaterials, and then definition of nanochemistry. So now let us study one by one in detail. Introduction of nanochemistry. As the name suggests, nanochemistry, it is the combination of nanotechnology and chemistry. The nanochemistry, it is the branch of nanoscience which deals with the chemical applications of nanomaterial in nanotechnology. In short, in nanotechnology, we can prepare the nanomaterials by using the chemistry, which is nanochemistry. The nanochemistry involves the study of synthesis and characterization of the materials of the nanoscale size. The nanochemistry, it is utilization of synthetic chemistry to make the nanoscale building blocks of the different nanocompounds, which is of different nano size and shape, composition, surface structure, charge and functionality. The few basic types of the nanomaterials, these are nanocrystals, nanotubes, nanowires and nanocomposites. Now then, what is meant by nanoscience? The nanoscience, it is the study of phenomenon and manipulation of material at their atomic, molecular and macromolecular scale, where properties differ significantly from those at a larger scale. Second is the, how do we define nanotechnology? The nanotechnology is the design, characterization, production and application of structures, device and system by controlling the shape and size at the nanometer scale. Then the question arises in our mind is, what is meant by nanometer scale? So next is, why nano, or what is meant by nano? The nano, it is the Greek word which meaning dwarf. But in actual, nano, it is the even smaller than the dwarf, and nanometer scale, it is defined, it is in between the 1 to 100 nanometer, and 1 nanometer, it is the 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. The material we see around us are bulk materials, means very large size materials that possesses the macroscopic physical properties. For example, the grain of sand, that is micron size material, also possesses the some bulk properties. Material synthesized at the nanoscale possesses the unique optical, structural, thermal, catalytic, magnetic and electrical properties. These various properties like optical, structural, thermal, catalytic, magnetic, electrical, these properties are changes as a function of their size and are very different from their bulk material. That means when the material, it is in the very large scale, that is macroscopic, and when these macroscopic compounds are converted into the micro compound, that is the in nano size, then these properties are vary from their size. Then, what is meant by nanomaterial? The nanomaterial, it is nothing but the material having structural components with at least one dimension in the nanometer scale, that is, as we already know, nanometer scale is in the range of 1 to 100 nanometer, and 1 nanometer, which is nothing but the 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. The nanomaterials are the larger than single atoms, but they are smaller than the bacterial cells. That means their size is in between the bacterial cells to single atom. These may be nanoparticles. Nanoparticles means their size is in the range of 1 to 100 nanometer. These are nanoparticles, nanowires and nanotubes according to their dimension. Now, what are their dimensions? These are the 0 dimension, 1 dimensional and 2 dimensional nanostructure. The nanostructure materials may be large organic molecules, inorganic cluster compounds and also metallic or semiconductor particles. Now these are 0, 1 and 2 dimensional nanoscale system. The first one is the 0 dimensional nanoscale structure. The example of this is nanoparticles. In the 0 dimensional structure is one in which all the 3 dimensions are in the nanoscale. The second one is the 1 dimensional nanostructure. The example of this is nanowires and nanorods. The 1 dimensional nanostructure is one in which the 2 dimensions are in the nanoscale. And next is the 3 dimensional nanostructure. Example is thin films. And the 2 dimensional structure is one in which 1 dimension is in the nanoscale. That means nanoparticles or the nanomaterials, it is of 3 categories. Either these are 0, 1 or 2 dimensional structure. Now in this table we have given the nanomaterial dimension, that is in all dimensions, 2 dimension, 1 dimension, nanomaterial types, for example nanoparticles, quantum dots, nanoshells, nanoring, microcapsule, 2 dimension, nanotubes, fibers, thin wire, films, layer, etc. These are the 0, 1 and 2 dimensional figures. And in this diagram we are given the figure of nanomaterials, that is of 0 dimension, that is cluster, 1 dimensional, nanotubes, fiber and rods, 2 dimension, that is films and coats, 3 dimensional, that is polycrystal. From this you have to get the idea how these are the various dimension shapes are found in the nanomaterials. Now next is the definition of nanochemistry. As we know, nanochemistry, it is the combination of nano and chemistry. Nano means nanotechnology. So it is the combination of nanotechnology and chemistry. That means in nanotechnology we have to prepare the different nano compounds or nanomaterials by using chemistry. So the definition of nanochemistry is, it deals with the designing and synthesis of materials of the nanoscale, that is materials of very small in size with the different size and shape, structure and composition and their organization into the functional architectures. The nanotechnology, it is used in the chemical, physical, materials, science as well as engineering, biological and medical applications. And as it is the combination of chemistry and nanoscience, by using this nanotechnology we can be prepared the various types of drugs and found their various effective effect in human body. And it is used in various types of techniques also. For example, in the cancer drug we have used the various nanomaterials which can be effect in the particular organs and not kill the healthy cells. So in this way we have to complete the introduction of nanotechnology, in which we have to study the definition of nanoscience, chemistry, what is meant by nanomaterial, what are the types of nanomaterials, that is 0 dimensional, 1 dimensional, 2 dimensional, what is the nanoscale, that is in the range of 1 to 100 nanometer, and 1 nanometer which is nothing but the 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. So in second part we have studied about the various characteristics features of the nanoparticles. Thank you.